T-Mobile USA proved it's ready, thanks to their world-first accomplishment of the nationwide launch of Standalone 5G, which includes Nokia's Core and RAN in a multi-vendor network. Standards are ready. 3GPP Release 16 takes us through enhanced mobile broadband and critical machine communications. Many devices are starting to come online, although a bit slower than I expected. It will be interesting to see the growth beyond smartphones and fixed wireless access into industrial devices and robotics. Most are in the planning stages for SA. So they're focused on choosing the path to SA, selecting the cloud model and security architecture, and defining their transition to automated operations. It's this last one that requires the most thought. Business processes, network rollout, and operations are all going to be completely different. Everyone's job is going to change. This means organization redesign and employee training on topics like DevOps and hybrid cloud. It also means that roles will change, from manual provisioning of services to creation of new services. This change is entirely in line with the digitization we're seeing in all industries. Repetitive work is removed with automation, freeing up people to work on higher value projects. People who work in technology fields are used to change, but this one will be more significant than most. It's a culture change, and this often takes time. Many will move just out of competitive pressure. It's hard to compete when every other operator has 5G and you don't. Another trigger we see is the promise of greatly reduced costs of operations. Older network cores just don't have the hooks to benefit from the end-to-end automation of DevOps or service orchestration. There are also customers who haven't yet moved to cloud. The cloud-native 5G core is a future-proof move, already proven to work on public, private, and hybrid cloud. Expanding into new markets is also a trigger, but this will follow in time after the other two. It will take another year before slicing compatible devices, applications, and proof points are there. When designing our 5G core, we've looked beyond the traditional boundaries of the core. Our 5G core consists of cloud-native products equipped with automation and intelligence integrated with security and orchestration software and running on all the cloud models. This fully cloud-native 5G core is ready now. Nokia is a leader in core networking and has been for years. Throughout our evolution to 5G, we've never lost sight of network fundamentals: reliability, scale, multi-vendor interoperability, security. Our customers can proceed with confidence. We know this space. All of our 5G core software is built on a common base, which is constantly adapted to run on new clouds. With this foundation across the core, all products evolve at the same time to new models. Our customers can choose the model appropriate to their business. We've also kept feature parity with previous 4G NSA. This means consistent functionality across all deployments. Customers can migrate at their own pace. When deployed on containers, we've used our experience in networking to overcome footprint performance issues while taking full advantage of improved upgrade, scaling, and deployment methods. These are built into a comprehensive automation framework. And finally, I'll come back to the platform idea. We've implemented an interesting enterprise use case recently in which a slice is orchestrated across the 5G core, and then the slice is exposed to the enterprise through the network exposure function, allowing the enterprise to create its own applications on top of its slice. It's use cases like this one that will really bring the value of the 5G SA core.